So hi to all, this is Gautam and my partner Mr. Pandian. So today we are going to see about the topic hydraulics in forklift. What is forklift? Where it is used? I said the hydraulics in forklift. What kind of hydraulics they are using in it? What is the viscosity index of the fluid? Which is the major industry they are consuming this forklift? So if you already heard about this topic or have a knowledge about this, please try to give answer to my questions in a comment section. Otherwise, you don't worry, that is why we are here. Let's get inside to the video. Forklift is a small industrial vehicle and it having a power operated forked operation at the front side. By using this, they can easily able to lift a weight from a ground level to a certain height, and along with that they can move from one place to another place also. This was the function of the forklift. This is why the reason the forklift is used in the most of the industries. Generally the forklift is powered by electrical source or a combustion engine. If the forklift is powered by electrical source, the battery is straight away connected to the wheels for a driving purpose. How the electric car works, how it drives power from the battery to the wheels, the same power flow happens in the forklift. If a forklift is powered by combustion engine, any one of the transmission system will exist in a forklift. The forklift is commonly used in godowns, warehouses, dockyards, snow plows. So these are all the common places we see the forklift is doing the operations and they are serving for us. We already seen what is forklift. Let us see what are all the systems they are using in a forklift. First one was a travel system. Second one was a material handling by using a hydraulics. Third one was a steering mechanism. Let us see all these systems in detail in one by one. The first one was a travel system. By using this system, the vehicle moves from one place to the other place. First of all, the vehicle is powered by engine or electrical source. If suppose the vehicle is, that means the forklift vehicle is powered by a battery, means that means the electrical source means the electrical power is straight away connected to the wheels to power it. If suppose the forklift is powered by combustion engine, there the transmission system existed. In that system consists of a torque converter or a transmission system to power the wheel. The second one was a material handling by using a hydraulic system. It consists of a three cylinders. The first one was a lift cylinder, tilt cylinder, power steering cylinder. Lift cylinder is a single acting cylinder. A flow control valve in the main line, it regulates the back flow. Due to that, its lowering is gradual and smooth. Gravity is not allowed to drop this in uncontrolled manner. Tilt cylinder is a double acting cylinder. That means it can push and pull. Generally, two type of tilt cylinders in a forklift, connecting to the right and left side of the stationary rails to tilt it. The next one was a power steering cylinder. It is a double acting cylinder, able to execute the forces in opposite directions. Push the wheels to the right and left turn. Let's go furthermore. What are all the parts they are using in a hydraulics in a forklift system? The first part was a hydraulic tank or reservoir. It is used to store the hydraulic fluid. For to do all the operations, the hydraulics is a must. That means steering, in order to lift a weight. So all the operation, hydraulics is a must. So before it is directed to the respective operations, it should have to store in a one safe place. That place is called a hydraulic tank. The second part was a hydraulic pump. It sucks the hydraulic fluid from the tank and then it elevates the pressure to a certain level and then it sends that pressurized fluid to the next level of operations. The third part is a flow divider or a priority valve. It actually blinds between the pump and the control valve unit. The fourth one was a hydraulic line or a hose. It is the line which sends the hydraulic fluid from the tank to the control valve and then to the respective cylinders. The fifth part is a pressure relief valve. In this, For to do the operation, pressure requirement is a must. If suppose the pressure limit is exceeded, the pressure relief valve releases that excess pressure and then sends the fluid to the hydraulic tank again. The sixth one was a control valve. It is used to start and stop the direction of a fluid and control with the fluid moves using the spools. Without the control valve, forklift pressure is a useless one. The seventh one was a hydraulic return filter, the return line which completes the cycle of a forklift. The eighth one was a tires. It was classified into four major groups. The first one was a pneumatic tire, pneumatic solid tire, cushion solid tire, poly tire. These are all the four major tires they are using in a forklift.
Hello everyone, I'm Pandya. Today we're going to see the working of an hydraulic system in a forklift. First of all, there should be a hydraulic tank, which is the mother of an hydraulic system. It consists of a suction line, return line, and then drain line. These three are the inputs and outputs. So there is a baffle plate given to it to control the tension of return line mixed with the suction line. An oil indicator is used to see the level of oil level in the tank. So the next component is hydraulic pump. In an hydraulic pump, there are several types in it. The most commonly used hydraulic pumps for the forklift is external gear pump.
Gear pump uses two gears rotating against each other to provide a fluid movement. One gear is a driven gear and another one is a drive gear. The drive gear is powered with the help of an engine or a motor is coupled parallelly with it. As the gear rotates away from each other and come out of mesh, they create an expanding volume on the inlet port of the pump. This creates the vacuum at the inlet port, allowing the fluid into the pump. Then fluid flows into the cavity and is trapped by the gear teeth as the gear rotates. The flow path is created around the outside of each one. Fluid trapped in between the teeth is carried around to the discharge into the outlet port. Meshing of the teeth at the center of the pump seals the outlet port from the inlet port, so no fluid passes between the gears.
Next components are priority valve.
Priority valve consists of three ports, namely inlet port, control flow port, and excess flow port. It mainly consists of a housing, main spool with metering orific, the spool biasing spring, and a relief valve. The metering orific controls the amount of flow priority circuit, means the steering circuit.
The excess flow tries to pass through the orific, but due to the increase in pressure, it pulls the spool and start to flow in the excess flow port. The conditions for the priority valve are: the control flow port is an pressure compensated, but the excess flow port is not. All the fluid first meet the demand to the control flow port and finally meet the excess flow port.
Next is the pressure relief valve. This valve helps to release the excess of pressure which build in the hydraulic system or hydraulic line. So the next component is the control valve.
For controlling the tilt cylinder, we use 4-way 3-position control valves, which has a 4 port, namely A, B, P and T, where A and B are the output and T is connected with the oil filter to the tank. Finally, P will be the pressurized fluid from pump. During normal condition, when the lever at the middle position, two ports are closed by the spool. So the fluid is not flow, so there is no action. When spool moved to the right port, B is open with P, which means the fluid flow to the cylinder, which helps to pull the cylinder rod. When spool moved to the left position, the port B is open with T and A with the B. So the fluid enters into the A side cylinder, which means the cylinder rod pushes. From the B side, the fluid will be back to the reservoir. Like in the similar manner, the lift cylinder were operated by a three-way two-position control valve for the lifting and down motion of the cylinder with the help of the single-acting cylinder.
So the next component is hydraulic lines or pipes. In the hydraulic lines, the line which sends the hydraulic from the tank to the control valve and then to the respective cylinders. This helps to connect all the component in a working manner. So the next component is the hydraulic return filter. The hydraulic return filter used to filter the oil from the return line of the control valve. The hydraulic return filter is the filter where placed in between the return line completes the cycle of the forklift. It is used in the system of oil filtration and return the oil to the tank back. So thanks for watching the video.
That's all about the presentation. Please tell the pros and cons about the video. Definitely we rectify the mistake in our next video. And I personally thanks to Mr. Jayant Joseph sir, because he only gave me a chance to present this topic in a YouTube platform in front of you. So thank you so much sir. Let us see you guys again in another video with a curious topic. Until then, please stay safe, stay in home, wear double mask, sanitize your hands. Moreover, please vaccinate, because the government is taking so many actions to combat this complex situation. So as a citizen of this country, we also have a responsibility to do this thing. So please vaccinate. See you guys.